cancer changed you?
Yeah, I think every experience that I have in life has changed me. And, but, you know, it's when you're at your weakest that God can be at his strongest. You can see him clearer when you have decreased and he can increase. And so spiritually, I'm stronger.
Whatever is giving you this calm, where does it come from?
I truly can tell you it comes from God. I put all of my hope and all of my trust in God and not in man. And he has sustained me. You get to a point where, you know, it's a saying that when you think you're down to nothing, God is up to something. To the point that I cannot control, I have no control over my destiny. I wake up, and some days I have good days, and some days I have bad days. I had to let go and let God. The operative part of that, you know, you've heard that phrase before, let go and let God. The operative part of that that most people don't discuss is, or mention is, that it's let go of your will and let God's will be done. I'm at a point now where I'm satisfied with whatever happens to me. And I'm all right with it because I know that my Heavenly Father watches over me, and I know he takes care of me.
Demonstrate in the civil rights movement inspired you in this battle?
Well, it has been all of my inspiration. As I preached about on Valentine's Day, Sunday, my mother has been a rock, and she's done it with such class and such dignity. And as we grew up, my mother and father used to tell us all the time, every tub must sit on its own bottom. Every tub must sit on its own bottom. And you have to make your way around it. you can't make it on me and you can't make it on your mama. You got to make your own way. But that type of strength and courage and love and commitment, and just knowing what your role is, and playing your role and doing the best you can, has really been the foundation that I have stood on as a child, as I participated as well as watched. Well, I was Ralph III, or Little Ralph.